update to a story Fox 13 News first reported. Environmental groups are petitioning the federal government to intervene on the Great Salt Lake.
This can no longer be a state of denial.
I'm Ben Winslow at Farmington Bay. A petition has been filed with the federal government seeking to have the Wilson's phalarope declared an endangered species. But I'm told it's just the beginning of a push to get more oversight over the Great Salt Lake. They sang and danced outside the Utah State Capitol, marking a new effort to save the Great Salt Lake.
Today, we submitted a petition to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to protect Wilson's phalarope under the Endangered Species Act.
The tiny migratory bird nests at the lake, and environmentalists accuse the state of simply not doing enough.
We don't see this as a battle between federal and state sovereignty. This is an opportunity to increase collaboration. It can bring people to the table to make sure that water gets to Great Salt Lake and make sure that we have the resources we need.
If it's granted by the federal government, an endangered species listing triggers new regulations and oversight of the Great Salt Lake.
The restoration of Great Salt Lake is no longer a local issue, a state issue. It's a national issue and with global consideration.
It's something some Utah political leaders oppose.
We're doing everything we can to save and preserve the Great Salt Lake. We feel very good. We're in better shape now than we've been in the last 5 years. So we don't think there's any need for a listing there, and we'll definitely push back on any potential listing.
But this may be just the beginning. Some backers of this petition are looking at endangered species listings for more birds and dust coming off the Great Salt Lake.
There are issues with air quality, both from airborne dust and the fact that the drying lake bed creates conditions where ozone forms more easily. And so we're looking at the Clean Air Act and if there are levers there that can be used to compel action to save the lake.
The air quality situation is a big concern because toxic chemicals are naturally occurring in the lake bed. An exposed lake bed blows dust into populated areas.
If there is a high particle event, stay indoors, wear masks.
Great Salt Lake dust was a topic at an air quality conference at Weber State University with a lot of research still underway. While Utah has experienced another good winter, there still is plenty of exposed lake bed.
You're being exposed to extremely high levels of just particulate matter, and that by itself is harmful in the short term.
Obviously, the solution to many of these problems is to get more water into the Great Salt Lake. State leaders insist they've enacted good policies that will do just that. Conservation groups say it's still not enough. At Farmington Bay, Ben Winslow, Fox